यस बच्चे, सो नाउ वी विल सी द केसेस ऑफ प्रोनाउन मीन्स व्हाट काइंड ऑफ प्रोनाउन सब्जेक्टिव और ऑब्जेक्टिव प्रोनाउन फॉर्म ऑफ प्रोनाउन विल बी यूज्ड. बेटा व्हेन इट इज यूज्ड एज ए सब्जेक्ट इट इज द सब्जेक्टिव केस शी एंड इन द ऑब्जेक्ट केस मीन्स ऑब्जेक्ट टू द वर्ब दैट विल बी हिम. जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस थिंग द सब्जेक्टिव एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव केस ऑफ द प्रोनाउन. I is subjective case, I, me is the objective case, we subjective and us is the objective. I think this thing is clear to you. Now what kind of case we should use, in particular rules we have to follow it up. Some particular rules, some particular words are there with the word between. With the word between beta, sorry. You should remember that you and me, these will be, we should use the personal pronoun in the second place. You and me, him and me, them and us, Hari and me. The second and third person will be used first on the first place, and the first person pronoun they will be used at the second place. Then with the complement of the verb be. But the be verb means is am are. Be is am are and was verb. Fine. Who is here? So in place of writing, it's me. Usually we say, when we speak this word in conversation, we use, it's me. Hana, let me. Then, but the correct form is, it is I. Subjective case is used. Subjective case means I should be used. This thing you should keep in mind. Yes. Now with the words, with the conjunction then. When this than is used, you know that this than is used for the comparison. They are richer than us. Subjective case of pronoun is used. We should use subjective case. We should use they are richer than we are. You are wiser than her. You are wiser than she is. Subjective case is used after than. Please wait a second, please. Yes. With the transitive verb. Transitive verb, you remember? Transitive verb. Transitive and intransitive. The choice between subject and object form depends upon what it meant. Means, with the transitive verb, there can be choice. Choice in the sense, it changes the sense with the sense of the sentence. Let's see this example. You hate him as much as I. Means you hate him as much as I hate him. If you complete the sentence, you hate him as much as me. Means you equally hate him and me. So with the use of this subjective and objective case, the sense of the sentence changes. He spoke to you as well as I did. Fine. Sorry. He spoke to you as well as I did. I spoke to him. He spoke to you as well as me. Means he spoke to you in the same way as he spoke to me. So with the use of the subjective and objective case, the sense of the sentence can change. In case of let objectivita, with the word this verb let, objective case is used. This thing, I think it is clear to you. Let me do it. Let us go for a walk. This is very much in your use. There is no problem. Yes, Vita. So, only a few rules you have to keep in mind. That is between, then how it changes the sense with the use of subjective and objective case. And the last one is with let. With the verb, let. Related sentences, beta, I will give you as the homework assignment. I'll send you. And with the other part, how to use a relative pronoun, it is very, very important that we'll discuss in the morning tomorrow. Fine. I hope you need not to get scared. Don't make such faces. Always, and the grammar is always done with the practice, beta. Don't think these, when I show you this, when these slides are shown to you, it is just kind of the reminder that you have done, you had been using. if you will check now, when you will do the exercise, you will feel it very easy. There is no problem in this. Because when we do practice, then we come to know the grammar concept comes more clear. Yes, on the book, you can check pronoun topic, page number 27. Page number 27, beta. You will do in the book only. Page 27, you will do in the book only, beta. First kind, side by side, reflexive and emphasizing. Beta, emphasizing, it emphasizes about the subject. I myself do it, means none other did it. Rather, I do it. Fill in the blanks with the correct pronoun. Exercise 37 is there. It starts from the 37. Fine. Then pick out the pronoun. Say whether they are reflexive and emphasizing. Here you will come to know the difference. Always remember, beta. No doubt answer key will be sent to you, but we will discuss further. Whenever we naturally, you know that your syllabus is going to complete. So we are going to open grammar book only in the coming sessions. Okay. And solve your queries. Yesterday I got the message from Jacqueline that she wants the, or in coming days we will discuss the speech also. Okay. If she is present over here. So we'll do it in the coming sessions. We'll solve all exercises. It should be done with you so that your queries are clear. Hana? Okay. We cannot devote so much time. If you will do it, if you will see all the solve the sentences yourself first, then you will come to know your problems and you can discuss with me. Clear? Okay. I'll send you the homework, beta, on page number 38, reflexive and emphasizing. Then 39, emphasizing and reflexive. These are the words you have to fill. They are the same, you know, but the use is different. Use is different. Then demonstrative. Just remember one thing, when a noun is used, it will be adjective. When that word is used as a subject or an object, that will be pronoun. You will be getting all these kind of exercises in coming exercises. You will having this concept only. ठीक है? Exercise चाहे ज्यादा हो, लेकिन आप जितना उनको solve करेंगे, तभी आपको वो concept उतना ज्यादा clear होगा. ठीक है? Okay? Yes, बेटा.